anyways, welcome back to the channel, y'all. Welcome back to the channel. Hope y'all doing great. Hold up, my intro. Hold up. What's good, everyone? Welcome back to the channel with yours truly. You know it, of course, it is Machiavelli. Hope y'all having a great day today. There you go. I got it. So today we're doing a speed build on a room, or a room build, you could say. I found a room like this on Pinterest. It looks really cool, so I thought I would try to recreate it, but add my own twist onto it, like twist. Sorry, guys. I'm singing of a song that had the name. Anyways, but yeah, guys. So leave your comments down below what you guys think of this build. You know, I always love reading them. I always thank you guys so much for the comments. Honestly, your guys' comments put the biggest smile on my face. I can't thank you guys enough for it. Thank you guys so much for commenting and all that. And some people have asked me in the last few videos about my social medias. My social medias will always be in the link down below. So is some CC that I use. I also show you guys some CC, like my main sites. They're always updating their sites. So some of them are not continuous, but some of them are where I get most of my CC from and most of my clutter from. So go check the description for that. If you want to follow me on social media, I have to do this because people keep on asking for this. You know, I always gotta do some self-promoting. If you want to follow me on social media, like Instagram and Snapchat, they're down below, of course, and that's actually the best way to contact me. If you need me for anything, I'm just blabbering right now, I'm just talking. If you need me for anything, if you have any questions, ask me. Of anything, Snapchat me or ask me on Instagram. Those are like the best way. You can ask me on YouTube, but then your comments always gonna get like shadowed out from everyone else. So those are the best place to talk to me if you need any questions, and I'm always here. I always reply back. Don't be shy to like start a conversation with me. Like I've been talking to so much of you guys on Snapchat. It's funny. Like I like snap stories with you guys like every other day. It's awesome. So don't be like afraid to talk to me. I'm a human being. I'll talk back to you. No worries, guys. No worries. But anyways, so hope y'all having a great day today. And today I got something funny to tell you guys, even though I told you guys already, but you guys weren't listening because I didn't record it. But it's not your fault. It's my fault. But I have a funny, not funny, I'll say funny story, but a story about how one comment ruined my future. Mm-hmm. One comment ruined my future. A comment by my teacher that didn't know me at all. Didn't know me at all because he did something stupid. But anyways, so pretty much what happened. But before I do that, before I even get into that story, I want to say a quick thank you to someone real quick. Vixen Simmer, if you're watching this, I want to thank you so much for subbing to me on my YouTube channel. I can't explain to you how much that means to me because you guys didn't know this. I started off my YouTube channel with doing Let's Plays, and they didn't do so well because, you know, I didn't know how to, like, my editing system was off. Not my editing system, my OBS settings were off, and it was a mess, and no one really wanted to watch my LPs, so I just deleted it, and I said I was gonna quit YouTube. But then I saw Vixen Simmer and Dasmin Simmer, I can't remember her name at the moment. They had all these beautiful cast videos that they did, and it really inspired me to start making casts, and that was really when my channel actually started. Guys, whenever I do my commentary, I always have to, like, get a stuffy nose or something. That's when our channel really started. So when she like reached out and she subscribed to me, and then I commented on her video, and then she told me that she likes my videos, it really was like a starstruck, like, oh my god, dang. The person that almost, like, I was ready to quit YouTube, and then this person inspired me to keep it going and said that she liked my videos, that was flipping crazy for me. So I want to thank you so much for that. Thank you all for everything. Honestly, it has really inspired me to do so much more with this, and I thank you guys so much. I love y'all. Y'all already know this, so let's keep it at bay. But yeah, I just want to say thank you to her and for everyone for everything. Honestly, you guys have been so amazing, so amazing, and I can't wait to keep this going, y'all, because it is 2017 and it's about to get popping this year. I can't wait for summer to hit, because, you know, constant videos, constant fun, constant time, good times with you guys. Can't wait. But let's keep it going till then, right? Y'all with me? Oh Jesus, I'm talking to myself like really bad right now, so I must be like, shut up and tell the story already. Okay, guys, I will. So anyway, so the story. So this is a story about my teacher. What happened was, when I first went to my high school, they put me in all college classes because my grades in middle school weren't the best. I will admit, they weren't the best. And I was like, no, I don't want to be in college. Because, you know, in my school, it was, you can either go to college or university. And everyone in my school, I went to a privileged, I won't say privileged school, but I went to school with a lot of rich people. I went to a school for stars, I guess you could say. It was a music school. I don't know. They had this thing. So you could either be a dancer, a singer, Yeah, dance, my bad. So dancer, singer, artist, or actor, something like that. Like those four prodigies, you know, four of them. I went there because of this borderline thing I was signed up for. It's like a special program thing, and I went there for that. But then I started to do music behind, like a little bit. Like I wasn't in the music program, but I did music. I did choir and all that stuff. So I got into the music group. So I started saying that I was a music kid, even though I wasn't, because you know I didn't want to stay out there for like special needs and stuff. So anyways, that happened. So I went to my high school for. So you guys are like, what do you go to high school for? Like, I went there for singing because I went there and I sang. But I actually went there for something else. But I went there for singing in my head because I sang a lot there. So anyways, keep it going. So I started off with all my courses were in college because of my disabilities and all that. They put me in the college level. I didn't want to do that. I want to show them that I'm smarter than that. That I can do better than that. So what happened was I did a full-on yearly upgrade, which was I had to take a class in college and take a class in university. Then when I passed the university class, I could upgrade to being a university, like a university kid. So I did everything was college. My English was college, my math was college, my social studies and all that were college level type of courses, and I didn't want to do that. I wanted to like really get out there and see what I could do with them. So I did the work and I was able to upgrade to university classes. So I'm a university student, you could say, and that was good. And so what happened was, when I went to grade 11, I decided that I went to a mixed course because that's the first time they ever offered mixed courses. So I thought it'd be cool, why not get to like see a mix? And the work, I'd say how the mixed class would be like, the work was university work, but the homework wasn't, like, I don't say college work, but it wasn't as hard as the university work. Like, it was the same stuff that university kids learned. It's just there wasn't as a lot of homework as there was. So I didn't really get like why they call it a mixed course. It was just like an easier university course, pretty much. So I guess that is mixed. I guess they were right. Anyways, so that happened. And so pretty much what happened was, in grade 12, there wasn't no mixed course. You could even go to university or college. I was gonna go for university calculus because I like calculus. Calculus was a cool subject for me. But this is where my life started to go. This is where something messed up my life. Anyways, so what happened was I when I was done that mixed course that was in grade 11, I ended up with like a 90 or an 80 something, a high 80, low 90s type of grade. And so my teacher recommended me that I did really good, and he recommended me that I do data management. My goal was to do calculus, but he said go with data management because I was really good in that area, which I wasn't. Note to self, I wasn't. But I didn't know that. I didn't know what data management was. I thought it was something like calculus or function, something like that, but it wasn't. It was not at all. It was word problems. So anyways, what happened was I took the course, and then the first week happened, and I thought it would be okay. The first week is a dropout week where you drop out and take another course. That first week was a dropout week, and I thought it was gonna be an easy course because the homework was chill and the teacher was chill. So I thought it would be plus my friends were in that class, so I was like, it's gonna be a chill class. So what happened was, like, I felt until I'll say in February, this is when it started to get like, oh my god, what did I do? Because mostly after this one, because we have like a few courses, like not courses, a few subjects. So after one subject was done, the first subject was done in January, the next few subjects were all word problems. If you guys don't know this about me, I suck at word problems. Like they're like the death of me with math. I can't do word problems. They suck. Like it was terrible. I can't do word problems. And I couldn't. And so after that once course, I just started failing. Like I started doing really bad in class. I started like my grades dropped. I went from being, after that one subject, I went from being a high 80 student to like a 60 student. Like by April, when finals were coming along, I was like a D, C student. Like it was bad. At that point, I didn't care about that course anymore. But then when we started doing colleges, and then we had to start putting out applications, this one course that I really want to go to said I had to get at least a 70 in the course to get accepted. So that's when I started really putting my hard work. We had two more subjects to go. I put in all my work into it, like everything I got, I put into doing that, and I couldn't do it. No matter how much I tried, the word problems would always get me down, and then I always ended up like failing I failed so many tests in that subject. It was terrible. But I got so many 40s and 50s, and it was just a mess for me. And I kind of broke down at one point because I was like, I'm not gonna get into the course. And so that happened. I didn't get into the course of my dreams. I literally planned on getting to that course for how many years now? I've planned on getting into that course since I was in grade 11, grade 10, grade 11, I was planning on getting to that one course, and then that one thing ruined it because I didn't get that grade point average. And then when I went on there to check what other courses I could have took instead of data management, I could have took calculus, I could have took this easy college course that I knew I could have like got with a 90s in, and that would have been fine. But you know, I didn't, because I followed my teacher and I ended up failing. So I didn't fail, I ended up with a 65, and you need a 70 to get in, so I didn't get to my course, which sucked. So I was just thinking about that the other day, because my mom was like, I told my mom about like this, like I told my mom that this subject, like what I'm doing right now, is like not really for me. I don't love it like I thought I would. She's like, just keep on going with it and maybe you'll find something you like. Like, you're not gonna like everything you like, but I'm like, I know that's true, mom, but like I hardly like what I'm doing right now. She's like, just keep on going with it, try it out, we'll see. Like, you already paid for it, right? So I'm doing it right now. And so I'm like, what up? Like, and I was like, what if I like did listen to my teacher and I actually took the right course? What would happen to me? Like, like what would have happened? And I was like, yeah. I was like, yeah. What would have happened? I'm like, damn, that one teacher for putting that. Like, if he honestly did not put a recommendation in my report card, I wouldn't have chose data management. I would have most likely chose like calculus or that easy course, the easy college course, and I would have gotten to that class right there, and then I might have not even been this type of person. Like, I might not even been a YouTuber, like thinking about that now, I actually might have not been a YouTuber, maybe because I was so like focused on that course, I had no time to do YouTube. Maybe my teacher did save my life. Wow, never mind, maybe he did, because if I never took this course, I would have maybe never, like, I've always wanted to start YouTube, but this course, I had the time to do it. Maybe with my other course, I would have no time to do it. So, yeah. Maybe he did save my life. I'm just thinking about it now. I'm like, wow, maybe he did. So you never know, right? You never know. Like, I honestly never know. I'm thinking about it right now. I'm like, wow. Maybe he did, but that's like a little story off. Like, I just thought it'd be cool to show you guys, like, share you guys, because you know, I like to show you guys a little bit. Like, I love to show you guys a little bit of insight on my life, show you guys like how I grew up, show you guys like the choices that I made growing up, because I want you guys to make the right choices. So I'm just saying, think before you do whatever you do. Like, don't always follow your teachers, because I always thought the teachers was the best thing. Like, if a teacher recommends to do it, get to it. But no, follow what you want to do. Do what you want to do. Don't always follow the teacher, because it's okay, because sometimes it's not the best for you. So just a little advice on that I took. So you never know, because honestly, thinking about it now, I may have never even started YouTube if I took that course. I may have done something else, I may have been doing something else right now, and you guys may have never learned Machiavelli. So actually, I thought I would hate that teacher, but I kind of thank him right now, because he brought me to this, maybe, because I don't know, you just never know what happens in the future, right? You can always say all these ifs, but wow, I'm actually, I came in this saying, oh my god, he ruined my life, but I don't know anymore. I honestly don't. I'm actually really happy right now. Okay, guys. So anyways, I'm going to end off this video here, guys. Thank y'all so much for watching. Of course, leave a comment down below, because you know this boy loves to read them. So thank y'all again for watching. Is there anything else I want to say real quick? I guess that's it. Yeah, I'm done. I'm speechless. Machiavelli is speechless. What? But anyways, I'll catch you guys on the flip side. As always, you know it. Deuces. I love y'all. Peace.